It's like you're coming. So today's session is friendly and distributed logging. So my name is Masahiro Nakagawa from the Treasure Data. And in this session, I will talk about the friendly and the how to use friendly for the container-based the distributed logging. Okay, the logging and the containers. So in this topic, I will show to the how difficult collecting the logs from the containers. Okay, thank you. Okay, currently we are now need to collect the logs for the production because we have a lot of log types. So one is the service logs. This is mainly for the business impact. So we need to collect the web access logs, so other impression logs, the transaction logs in the game or e-commerce. This is used for the KPI monitoring or the machine learning for the improvement of the business product. And on the other hand, we also need to collect the system logs. This is for example, syslog or systemd log, or of course, audit logs for the security, the metrics of the CPU and memory monitoring for the system checks. So this is very important for the services because if your system is not good to, performance, it is not good for the users. So we need to collect these several type logs for the production. But we are now on the container era. So this is something different for the logging because the system architecture is changed from the monolithic big application to the microservices with containers. And in container, the systems are immutable. So we need to update the images and upload it for the updated systems. And one important point is that data is ephemeral. So if we restart the containers, the data is destroyed. So we need to collect the container data before the restart. And so container is moving, so we can't assign the fixed addresses in each containers. So unlike the old server era, so we can't use the server address for the grouping or the groupings for the assigned tasks. So it means we have several difficult problems for the loggings. So logging as ephemeral, so container is ephemeral storage, so it means that we need to transfer the logs to the anywhere as possible when generated the logs. And so we can't use the addresses, so we can't pull the data from the containers. So it means that containers should push logs to the outside by itself. And of course, we use the microservices. It means lots of application types. So it also means we have a lot of log types and log transport method. So one is a file, one is a networks, and one is a system syslogd or systemd. So we need to handle these various log types in the collection logging daemons. So to resolve these problems, that we can use the friendly. So and I explain the friendly overview how to friendly handle these problems. So this is very simple description. So what is friendly? So friendly is an extensible and reliable data collection tools. So extensible means that friendly has a simple core for the log forwarding and the log collecting. And if you have a domain-specific problems, it is processed by the plugins. So friendly keep to core is simple, and you have a lot of plugins for resolving the specific problems. And friendly is reliable. Reliable, it means the friendly core has several good features for the log transfers and log collecting. So buffering for the improvement, improve the performance, and HA for the stable log forwarding, and of course secondary or retry for the avoiding the log lost. And the data collection tool, it means very it's simple. So it's like a syslogd. So if you put the friendly, you can easy to start the log collecting in the streaming manner. So this is very basic image. So without friendly's log collection mechanism. So friendly can provide the Intel plugin. Intel plugin works to the file, and the if application generates the logs to the file, friendly gets the log content immediately and send it to the destination. In this image, friendly sends the data to the log server. So this is a very low latency. With traditional approach, we need to wait the log rotation. So it needs it is a very high latency, so 1 hour or 1 day or something. And all transfer tools like rsync or send the data to the log format. So you can need to you need to analyze parse the data in the log server side. But friendly uses the structured logging approach. So if friendly gets the data, the passed into the structured formats. So you can easy to pass, and you can easy to mutate the logs events in the log server side. So friendly is resolving the several problems in the for the data integration. So the without friendly, you need to write the several scripts getting the data from the data sources and send to Hadoop or other data sources. And if sometimes the implemented language is different. One is a shell, one is a Python, or one is a Golang. So this is a very messy and a complicated problem for the data integration. So with friendly allows you to unify the data pipeline. So you can using the friendly, so you don't need to write any code for the several data sources and data destinations. And this is easy to extend by the plugins. So we call this mechanism is a unified logging layer. And this is the overview of the friendly. So next, so we showed the friendly architecture to learn how to handle the data streams in the friendly. So this is a simplified architecture of the friendly internal. So friendly has several components for processing the data. And these four components are important in the data pipeline. So we showed these four components. So data from the pass through the right to left. So input plugin getting the data from the data sources, and input plugin and emit the data to the filter and the buffer and output. The important point is the log format. So in the bottom right, we show the time and the target and the record. So in the friendly gets the logs in the input side. So input converted the one log line into these structured format, so time and tag and record. So you can see the you can identify the logs. So time is a log log happened time, and the tag is for identifying the what the application generates logs. So you can easy to find the this log is come from. What the application, so this metrics log or application log or something. And the record is not text text line. So it is a JSON, so key value pairs. So because recent systems accept the JSON format, so Elasticsearch or MongoDB or something, so using the JSON is instead of text line is better for the data integration. And we want to sometimes modify the data in the pipeline. So for example, adding the metadata or adding the geolocation from the IP address. So in this case, so how to modify the data is when record format is the text. So we use the JSON format for the event payload. So I forgot to mention. So friendly has a buffer before the output, because this is mainly for the improve the performance and the improve the reliability. So buffer merges the incoming event into the chunk, so it reduces the out flash cost. So and the it merges the very small request into the large chunks. It improves the throughput. And the, it creates the whole. And if you use the buffer files, so buffer files is stored into the local disks. So if the server or friendly crash, yeah, buffered events are kept on the local disk. So you can easy to resume the data pipeline in the before state. So this is why friendly uses the buffer components before the output. This model is how to literalize the friendly. How to literalize friendly is friendly's streaming manner. So I said that friendly uses a streaming manner for the data collection, data log forwarding, and it means that friendly separated the data streams into the small chunks. You know, I said the buffer. So in this model, this is easy to literalize because this is a chunk is small. So if this transferring the failed, this is easy to retry because the size is small and the, unlike the batch model. And this is a recovery model for the friendly. So sometimes destination server is down, so network error or overloaded. In this case, friendly of course friendly started to literalize. The friendly default algorithm is using the exponential backoff, so it means literalize overload is lower than the periodic interval. So this is good for the destinations. And also, friendly has several custom parameters to mitigate the recovery. So if sometimes destination is bugs, retry data is frequently happens. In this case, retry request is very often, the number of retry requests is increasing. It causes system shutdown again. So to mitigate this problem, friendly has several parameters to mitigate the frequent retry, so changing the flash interval between the queue of chunks in the buffer. So if your destination is a low capacity, so friendly can flash the slowly for such destinations. So friendly has several flow control for the buffering flash interval, flash and the recovery. And friendly has lots of plugins for the input and output. So for the input, for example, friendly can data consume the from the Kafka or getting data from the system metrics using the DF or Twitter or SQL for the RDBMS. So you can collecting the lots of data from the lots of applications. And of course, output has more plugins. So you can send the logs in the very many lots of places. So AWS, GCP, or Microsoft, Azure, or of course Elasticsearch, Kafka, or more destinations. So you can change the only configuration. You can change the send to destination. So no need to write the code in your data pipeline. So this is good for the container-based system because container system lots of application. So you can easy to change the application by the configuration, via the configuration settings. So in this session, next topics, distributed logging. So in the container, so this, we have a lot of containers. It means that logs are distributed. So we need to collect the logs from the lots of containers for the data analytics or data stores. So I talk about how to use the friendly or the distributed logging cases. Okay, distributed logging, so there are three roles. One is a source. A source is consists of two components. One is the application container, and one is the agent. Agent is typically is a friendly or other several some monitoring agents, like data log or something. Next is aggregation layer. This is mainly for scalability and stability. So I will talk about it. I will talk about this point later. The destination. Destination is very simple. So your destination storage, so Hadoop or Elasticsearch or cloud services. Okay. And each roles has each tasks. So source. A source is needed to get the retrieve logs from the file or network or API. So mainly container generated logs to the standard output or something. So we need to collect these logs. Of course, if you are using the friendly, so need to pass the payload for the structured logging for the further next layer's computation. Aggregator is simple. Aggregator is get logs from the multiple sources to the collecting the source layers. And the important point is aggregator should, the task is splitting or merging the logs into the streams. This is mainly for the network efficiency, or this is mainly for the splitting the traffic into the small traffic. This is for the scalable logging. Okay, destination is okay. So receive logs from aggregator, so stores data into the a local file or S3 or something. Yeah. So the important point, source layer, I said that you friendly need to collect logs from the containers. So how to collect logs? So friendly has several ways to get the logs from containers. In this talk, I assume that the container is running on the Docker, but maybe similar approach is as other container engine can support the similar approach. Okay, one is a logging driver. So logging driver is a Docker feature for Docker features. So this is very useful for the collecting applications output to the routed to the other destinations. And Docker logging driver supports the friendly in the core, so you can use this logging driver to collect logs from the container to the send to the friendly without no additional dependency. So, and in this model, so Docker collects the output logs in the native way. So, your container or your application don't need to write any code. If you just write the logs to the output, Docker collect the logs and send it to the friendly. So this is very easy. Next way is using the friend logger. The friend logger is a library for the sending logs to the friendly via the friendly's forward protocol. Yeah, the demerit is that you need to write the code in the your application, but you can export any metrics into the friendly directory. So you can do the distributed tracing-like mechanism by this approach. Of course, Flint Logger is supported by the many languages, so PHP or Ruby or Python or Rust or Golang or something. So maybe your application can use this approach for sending the metrics. And next is this is mainly for the middleware, the containers, so using the shared volume. So I said the Flint Tree has an Intel mechanism to watching the file to get the logs immediately. So we use the Flint Tree's Intel for the tailing the container's shared volume to collecting the data from the without modification. So this approach is using in the Kubernetes. Kubernetes. So Kubernetes uses a Flint Tree and this shared data volume approach to collecting the Apache or Nginx logs, so they send to the Elasticsearch Kibana to visualize the data traffic. So this is popular in the Kubernetes, Kubernetes-like orchestration tools. So we have several, I showed the three approaches, so for the collecting the logs from the container. So you can select the logging method for each purpose. So easy to way is using a logging driver to collect the logs from the application's output. And if you want to send any specific metrics from the application, you can use the Flint Logger. And if you can't modify the middleware settings, yeah, you can use the shared data volumes to with the Flint Tree's Intel mechanism. So this is also good for the collecting the middleware logs. Of course, you know, you can also continue putting the Flint Tree in the container and the collecting using the Flint Tree plugins to collecting the system metrics or something. Okay, we can collect the container's logs. So the next problem is how to deliver these container logs to the destination. And we have several deployment patterns for on the production. Now we show the actual example with Flint Tree. So this is a very old and primitive deployment. So this model sending the data, application sending data to the destination directly. So this is a very primitive, so no Flint Tree cases. So this has several problems. So one is the application should know the destination side settings in the containers and the image. So it means that if you change something in the destination side, so IP address or cluster settings or the changing the destination middleware, you need to restart the all application. So this is very managed to, this is hard to manage the containers. And another problem is this is need to the container, the number of containers to send to the lots of connections into the destination. So it means the small requests, middlewares receive the lots of small requests in the destination side. This is okay for the cloud-like services, but some middleware is not good for the small requests. For example, Elasticsearch or MongoDB. These middleware's import request is a high cost. So if you lots of the small import requests, sometimes Elasticsearch, like the middleware, is overloaded and it causes the system trouble. So we should avoid the small requests for the middlewares. So avoid these problems, we can use the Flint Tree put in the source side. So we call the source side aggregation. So this has several merits. The one merit is the configuration is decoupled from the application. So application don't need to care the destination settings and the friendly freeze the logging pain from the application. So I said that friendly has a good features for the buffering or HA or retry mechanism. So just containers application just send logs to the friendly. Friendly send the logs to the destination efficiently. So if the destination side is shut, the troubles, friendly bufferings and retries smoothly. So this is very good for the application. And friendly's buffering mechanism merges the small request into the chunks. So it is also good for the destination. So friendly don't send the small requests frequently in the destination. So this is good performance for the Elasticsearch or MongoDB like middlewares. And next model is destination side aggregation. This is mainly for the high traffic environment. So if the traffic is high and there are lots of containers or servers, so source side aggregation is not enough for the destination side. So in this case, we put the friendly on the destination side and built the multi-tier aggregation to reduce the number of requests on the friendly protocol has a good have a load balancing on the active standby or active model. So if your traffic is high, friendly can handle these traffics in the very efficient ways. So this is good for the high traffic environment. So this is a summary of the why we use the aggregation servers. So if logging directly from the containers, it has sometimes a problem with the too many connections and the frequent API calls. So put the aggregation before the destination side, so it resolves the problems. So friendly merges the connection into the small chunks and the buffer for the throughput. And of course, friendly has a good retry mechanism, so it prevents the log loss during the destination time downtime. So aggregation server is good for the scalable logging. Hey. This image is a summary of the simplified image. So you can select the your best approach deployment pattern is from this images. So if your traffic is lower, so maybe only source side aggregation is better. So this is lower small containers, and the friendly can handle the container loggings efficiently. And if your environment has high traffic, so please put the destination side aggregation. So yeah, yes. So please, if you use the distributed loggings, so source side aggregation is a good start point for the collecting logs from the containers. And so destination side is depends on the UI environment. So good for the high traffic, or if your destination has a don't have a good strong point for the frequent request, maybe please use the destination side aggregation. It resolves several problems in the high workload or several problems. Okay. So this is a key point of the scalable distributed logging. So this is similar to the distributed processing. So if you have a heavy traffic, so it should be split into the small traffic to the several nodes. So it is easy to recover from the heavy traffic. And if you have lots of connections, please let's merge the connections into the small connections. So it reduces the problem of the lots of requests. And the CPU and the memory. So of course, heavy processing should be done in the data analytics layer, so Hoega, Hadoop, or data warehouse or something. But sometimes we want to use the several computation in the data pipeline. Yeah, it should be distributed to the several nodes. For example, the machine learning or something. Yeah, it should be not, it should not be in the one node, should be distributed. And of course, we for scalability, we need to do the HA features. So if we have a lot of containers or lots of servers, so sometimes the container is crashed, the server is crashed. So we should recover from the failure cases. So for those cases, Frontly has a built-in HA cases. So if one destination is crashed, Frontly switches from that to another node. And of course, load balancing is also a good feature for the balances the traffic into the more small nodes. Actually, so we said so we should avoid the reconfigure for systems when, if when modifies the destinations. So please decouple the configuration of the several settings should be separated to each component, not to depend on the other components. So this is a side conclusion. So Frontly, I talk about the how Frontly solved the container logging mechanism. So Frontly's pluggable model is fit for the lots of application types. So Frontly provides lots of plugins, and so you can collect the logs from the lots of applications by changing the configuration. And Frontly's robust sort of buffering on the literal mechanism. Yeah, easy to send the data to the destinations with a robust way. And of course, Frontly has supporting the typical deploy patterns, so we can use the source side aggregation and the destination side aggregation and both aggregation. So you can select the good deployment pattern for your requirements. And of course, we are now have a several good product under the CNCF for the scale systems, so orchestration for the Kubernetes and the monitoring for the Prometheus. Of course, logging for the Frontly for the logging. So we can use the, we can now easy to make the scalable and stable systems for the your business or services. Okay, enjoy logging, thank you.